This is a seahorse. His name is Mango and his best friend is Banana. They are a pair of rare seahorses that come all the way from Hawaii. They will be best friends for life. How did they get here all the way from the Big Island? Were they taken from the ocean and put on an airplane? What do they eat? And why do they grab onto my finger? Let me tell you about how they got here. Mango and Banana come from an organic aqua farm on the Big Island in Hawaii. After weeks of planning, they finally arrived in this one-day shipping container. Let's quickly transfer them into their new tank. After 20 minutes of acclimating, they were in. It's time to give them a snack. Since Mango and Banana are captive-bred seahorses, they will eat frozen food. These are frozen mysis shrimp. They're jam-packed with nutrients and high in minerals and vitamins that seahorses need to survive. Look at how cute they are when they eat. It's my favorite thing in the world. If you know me, you know that I tend to create freshwater aquariums, like this one I made for my axolotl Lucy. But I also have a saltwater setup with clownfish and rainbow bubble tip anemone. They're absolutely beautiful and so much fun to care for. My favorite thing to do is to feed my anemone snacks. I've dreamt of getting seahorses for years, and the time has finally come. Let me show you how I built their new home. I wanted to replicate their natural environment, so I used a combination of dried reef rock and coral skeleton to build a structure. This epoxy stick will help bond the stone and sponge skeleton together instantly. These pieces will provide excellent places for my seahorses to hang out. Seahorses love to anchor onto coral and other objects in an aquarium. It allows them to take a break from the flow and to rest and feed. I don't normally use plastic in my setups, but this red coral is another great ornament for my seahorses to hold onto. Having colorful objects in the tank helps to bring out the natural colors of the seahorses. This is reef aragonite sand. It's a great host for beneficial bacteria and will provide a great base for our seahorse tank. Let's rake it smooth and clear a space in the center to place our reef structure. If I'm lucky, my pair of seahorses may even have babies someday. Did you know that the male is the one that gives birth? It's time to fill it up with salt water. I use this cup to ensure the water remains clear. Saltwater tanks are more difficult to keep than freshwater, but typically the fish are much more colorful and unique. Let's turn on the filters. Seahorses are the slowest fish in the ocean and require slow flow in an aquarium. Be sure your filters are adjusted accordingly. This filter sock will help to remove small floating particles from the water. This tank will need to cycle a few weeks before we can welcome our seahorses home. Once the cycle is complete, we can add our skimmer. This will help to remove organic compounds from the water. I absolutely adore my seahorses, Mango and Banana. After a long journey across the United States, they have finally found their forever home. Thanks for watching!